Hi everyone, welcome you all. In this video, as part of robot framework, we are going to discuss about how to use variables. What are the different type of variables and how to declare those variables and how to use those variables. And if you go back to your previous example, so here in the test case, I have used some certain kind of variables, right? So here browser and URL. So these are the two different variables I have used, and I have just created two variables. I'm just use those variables inside our test case, right? So similarly, we can also create a different type of variables. So currently we have a different type of variables. The first type of the variable is called scalar variables. So we have a scalar variable, and we have a list type of variable, and we have a dictionary type of variable, and we have environment type of variables. So there are four kinds of variables we have: scalar type of variable, list type of variable, dictionary, and environment variable. Along with this, we also have some built-in variables. So built-in variables. So these variables are provided by the robot framework itself. So they are called built-in variables. There are four types of variables we have. So let us see what is the difference between these variables and where we have to use and how do we have to use. Let's go to your PyCharm. So inside this PyCharm, so I already created these two variables, right? So these are all comes under the scalar variables. So these two are comes under the scalar variables. So scalar variables we have to define like this. Scalar variables, the syntax will be dollar in the curly braces, specify the variable name and two spaces, and then we have to specify some value here. So this is a simple scalar variable. And these are all scalar variables. So whatever we have seen just now, and browser, URL, so these are all called scalar variable. So we have used these scalar variable here by specifying the dollar. And within the curly braces, we have to specify the scalar variables. So there is another type of variable called list type of variables. So list type variable contains many number of values. Suppose here, this variable can hold only one value at a time. Suppose sometimes we need to store multiple values into single variable. In those cases, we can define the list type of variable. So let me just define one more variable in the same test case. So along with these URL and browser, I will create one more list type of variable, but the list type of variable, the syntax will be like this. So here it will start with the @ and the curly braces. And here I'll just the variable name. Here I'll specify variable name and two spaces, and then we specify the value 1, and a value 2, and so on. So we can specify any number of values, but here we should give two spaces, okay, not comma. So we can specify multiple values inside this single variable. This is called list type of variable, and it should start with the @ symbol. Now let's create a variable of list type of variable. So let me just say @. And here I will just specify credentials. I'll just say credentials. So this is my variable name. And what are the credential values? Give two spaces, and credentials are admin is my username, and two more spaces, and then admin123 is my password. So these are all my credentials. So now this is a variable. What type of variable it is? It is a list type of variable, and which contains two different values. Now, how we can use them in our test case? So in our test case, I have hard coded these values, right? Admin and admin123. So instead of hard coding these values, I'm going to refer this particular value from this credentials variable. But how we can refer that? So here, just remove this hard code value and specify @ in the curly braces, and same variable name we have to specify credentials. And from this variable, we have two values. I want to extract only first value. So the index will start from 0 here. I'll say 0 as my index. So from this 0 index means admin will be retrieved. So now this particular admin username will be displayed here. And now the password, this time I will take from different variable. So let me also create one more dictionary variable. So this is a list type var variable. When I say index number 0, it will get admin. When I say 1, it will get admin123. Okay. So I'll create one more variable. So first two are scalar variables. This is your list type of variable. Now I'm going to create a dictionary variable. So if you want to create a dictionary variable, the syntax will be like this. So here, dollar and symbol, and in the curly braces, we should add the variable name, and here give some space, two spaces, and in dictionary the values will be stored in the key and value pair. So here let's say k key value, let's say k1 means key value, and the value of the key is something else. So here we need to say value1, and again give two spaces and another key and the value. So like this we can give any number of key and value pairs. So basically the dictionary will store key and value pairs. We can have any number of values, but every value we need to refer with the key value, key with the key. So this is a dictionary variable. Let us create one dictionary variable here, and we have to use and symbol. Okay, and in the curly braces here I will just say some variable name is login data. I will give login data is my variable name, and two spaces, and the key is I'll say username. The value of the key is admin, and give two more spaces, and the key value is password, and is equal to admin123. So this is my password, and these keys can be anything. Okay, so these are not keywords. You can just say any variables, you can just specify any alphabet. So this is a username is a key, admin is a value, password is a key, admin123 is a value. So like this we can store key value pairs, any number of key value pairs inside this dictionary variable. Now how we can refer this? So here in the password field I have hard coded some data, but this time I want to take from this dictionary variable. So how to refer that variable is you can just specify the same variable here, but how we can extract this one? So we have to specify in the curly brace square brackets, we have to specify the key, exactly the same key here, and now whatever key we specified exactly that value will be captured here. Okay, so this is how we need to refer the dictionary variable. So the username I'm getting from the list variable, and the password I'm getting from the dictionary variable. You can also get from one of them, okay, no issues, but I just here I want, my intention is I want to show you both the type of variables. So now I have substituted here list type of variable, and here I used scalar variables, and this is your list type of variable, this is your dictionary variable. Okay, now let's execute the code till here, and then we'll see other two types of variables. Now let me execute my code, robot, and name of the test suit. Just press enter. Now it is started execution. Now it is launching my browser. So once it is launched, now it is entering the username and then entering the password, then click on the login and successfully executed. Right, so my test case is passed. So now I have referred three different variables, scalar variables, then list type of variable, then dictionary type of variable. Now we have other two types of variables called environment variable and built-in variables. So normally environment variables are the variables or system variables. Let me just show you a few environment variables. Let's open the command prompt. So if I see here percentile, suppose if I want to see the username of this particular system, I can say percentile, let's say username, and username and percentile plus enter, it will give you the username. Let me just write one more time. I'll just say echo is a command, echo and space username. Now it will give you username of your system. Similarly, you can get everything from your system, the username, like operating system, what operating system currently we have, like all kinds of information we will get by using this environment variable. So this variable having some value here. So if you want to use this environment variable values, we can use this environment variable. Let me just use one of this environment variable here is, after closing my browser, I'll just write one command called log. So this command will print that message in my as my output in my report. So log, two spaces, here I'm just writing something, right? So this is this test is executed, or this test is ran by, okay, and I want to print the username here. I want to refer the environment variable. So how we can refer is percentile in the curly braces, specify the environment variable username on which operating system I can specify here, or which browser also I can specify here. Browser name we don't know exactly here, we don't have any environment variable for the browser, but here we can just say OS. Okay, this will give you the OS environment variable. So percentile username and percentile OS. So log, this is a test ran by percentile username and on OS. These are all environment variables. These two are environment variables. Now let us execute this test case and see. And let me run one more time through command prompt, robot, first test suit dot robot, enter. Now it is started execution. The output of this log we can see in the log file. I'll show you after completion of execution. Now it is entering admin, clicking on the login. Now it's executed. So it is passed, right? Now let us see the report here. Report.html, just open this in some browser. And what is the message we have? This test is ran by so-and-so username and operating system. So those values we should able to see that. So just go to log here. Inside the log, your test case steps will be displayed. Now expand your test. Just go to the last step, okay? If you expand the last step, and here you can see that output message. So this test is ran by admin on particular operating system, right? So this is a message, you got it. So these are called environment variables. So far we have discussed about scalar variables, list variable, dictionary, environment. And the last one is built-in variables. So there are built-in variables are available. So they are provided by robot framework itself. So if we just go to robot framework documentation, okay, there we will get all the built-in environment variables. Just go to robot framework documentation page. This is official document, not this one. Okay, let's go back. Robot framework user guide, sorry. Robot framework user guide. So here we can find a certain number of built-in keywords. Let me just control F, and here I'll just type about built-in variables. Built-in variables, press enter. Built-in variable. Let's, or else we can just go to variables. Just hold on. I think not here. Somewhere it should be listed out. Let me just cross check. So our robot framework user guide, or we can say variables. So directly we can verify it. So click on this one. Okay, so I think here click on the variables. Now here somewhere you can see control F, built-in variables. Okay, so so here you can find few number of built-in variables. Okay, so here, so built-in variables, click on this link. Now it will show you there are few variables are available: current directory, temporary directory, execution directory. Okay, there are a lot of things. So these built-in variables we are going to use sometimes, like if you want to get the current project directory or current test case name or current test suite name. If you want to get all of them, just we can use this built-in variables in your test script. Okay, so we are also going to see how we can use these built-in variables in the coming videos. So here, there are the four types of variables: scalar variables, list variable, dictionary variable, environment variable, and finally, built-in variables. So we have seen how to declare those variables, how to refer those variables in your test cases, and we have executed our test case, right? So that's all for this video, guys. So we'll see rest of them in the next video. So thanks for watching.